Hey, how's it going? My name is Anya Mielniczek and I am a mixed media artist. I'm also a muralist and I work a lot with garbage. So my background is actually in fine art. That's what I went to school for. I've been practicing ever since I finished school. In school, I was learning oil painting, sculpture, printmaking, time-based media, but it came really apparent to me really early on that I loved absolutely all materials and really I'm fascinated by like all art production. Prior to that, I was focusing on more fine art pieces, showcasing my work in shows, applying for exhibitions and stuff like that. The work that I produce speaks a lot to the environment, and when I got the chance to actually work outside physically, it changed absolutely everything. Like, if I could be painting while I'm outside in nature, it's like a win-win situation. So I am focusing a lot on the murals right now, working with installations, and working a lot with garbage because there is just so much pollution in the world. And I find that any material really holds a certain value and a certain weight to it. And all it really needs is just a human touch to it. I would say I really love pencils and I really love pens. Before anything, I always doodled in high school and drew in my notes. So I definitely have a soft spot for pencils and for pens. I love them. Probably pens more. There really is no one material that I cannot live without because every body of work that I'm creating usually ends up using completely different materials than the last series that I was working with. I've actually found it super exciting to me because it definitely allowed me to create more pieces for myself than I have in a really long time. The last couple years have really been a lot of work projects that have stacked one after the other, and most of these have been mural projects. So it's been like a lot of exterior latex paint, a lot of spray painting, and with this lockdown, I found that it really gave me a moment in time to actually start creating with my upcycled materials. So, I mean, we're all home, we've all been snacking and eating, and I definitely am very conscious of like the waste that my household produces in and of itself. There are certain materials that I started to collect over the last year, which includes plastic bottle caps, and this can be from, you know, drinking bottles, shampoo bottles, medicine bottles, condiment bottles, any plastic cap that you can think of. The lockdown also didn't really allow me to use spray paint, so I have a wall of spray paint behind me, but I definitely took a pause on the spray paint. It allowed me to, yeah, experiment more, come up with different variations or utilize materials that I was maybe using one way in a different way. I started cutting water bottles and just actually keeping just the top. And this way I've been arranging like, you know, 20, 30, 50 of these caps, like side by side. Which is a new kind of look and feel to me. For me, working with the garbage this time around, during this time, it's been a nice sort of like moment of reflection. Again, just seeing how much waste we produce every week, especially when we're not leaving our homes, and how fast it accumulates and what kind of garbage even my household accumulates the fastest, and starting to collect that and then starting to process that into work and thinking about the work more on a grander scale, like how can I actually utilize this stuff, this garbage, this material, into work that I can be creating publicly this year. I got into a flow over a month of actually doing live Instagram live workshops utilizing the waste that I had collected over the week and producing a waste art piece out of this garbage, and really trying to invite people to also collect, you know, maybe their garbage from their week, and showing kind of the methods and the links they use to create art out of waste. One of my good friends that I actually studied with in university, a fellow artist, her and her husband actually started a little art challenge So there was a few of us that would meet by Zoom, via Zoom, every Tuesday, and we would come up individually with a cue or a theme for the week, and then all of us would create art with regards to that theme. I was as well connecting with the art community through social media, whether it was Instagram or Facebook groups, chatting with friends more on the phone, not just texting. It was really nice. It was really, really nice.